Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Early today or yesterday, depending on your time zone, SpaceX launched the Starlink 4-2 and Blue Walker 3 mission.
One, ignition, and lift off of Falcon 9. Go Blue Walker 3, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1058, then landed successfully for the 14th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitors.
Stage one landing burn.
And there you can see that single engine lighting up your left hand screen as Falcon 9 attempts to land on our drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
Landing leg deploy. Stage one landing confirmed.
And great news, Falcon 9 has landed. This is a record-breaking 14th landing for this booster. An awesome view there on your screen. This is the 141st landing of an orbital class rocket, including Falcon 9. That includes Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy missions. And we just heard confirmation of good orbit as well on the second stage.
SpaceX posted a tweet about this mission in which Elon Musk responded. He said, "One of our most complex missions. We can hopefully expect another Starlink mission to launch very soon as well." As you can see on the SpaceX fans website, the Starlink 434 mission is expected to lift off on Wednesday 14th at 2:30 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 13th at 10:30 p.m. EDT. Musk posted a tweet about reusing Falcon 9 rockets. He said, "No obvious limit to rocket reflight so far." Somebody posted a tweet saying, "Hopefully Apple partners with SpaceX's Starlink to help connectivity with the new iPhone 14 via emergency SOS with the satellites." Musk responded and said, "We've had some promising conversations with Apple about Starlink connectivity. iPhone team is obviously super smart. For sure, closing link from space to phone will work better if phone software and hardware adapt to space-based signals versus Starlink purely emulating cell tower." Teslarati posted an article with news about SpaceX securing more launches. It says SpaceX has been chosen by Sidus Space for 5 launches in 2023. Sidus Space, which is focused on satellite as a service, announced. Sidus chose SpaceX due to its safe and reliable launch services. There is another article posted by Space News about even more payloads that SpaceX will be launching. It says Iridium will launch 5 of its remaining 6 ground spare satellites on a Falcon 9 rideshare mission in 2023, the company announced September 8th. There was an article posted related to information about SpaceX making a change to Starlink prices to make them cheaper. It says the change has been discussed on Reddit and a user established a crowdsourced database of Starlink terminals and service changes by nation. As of this writing, the database contains complete records for 39 nations. The average terminal price including shipping is $493.99 and the average monthly service charge is $72.65. In 8 nations, the service charge has been cut by over 50%. There was an article posted related to SpaceX Starlink mobile plans. It says SpaceX is requesting that the FCC grant it even more radio spectrum for the company's upcoming Starlink service for mobile users. The company on Tuesday filed for access to the 1.6 GHz and 2.4 GHz bands to power Starlink's mobile satellite service, which is being designed to deliver internet access in cellular dead zones. There was another Starlink article posted. It says SpaceX appealed the Federal Communications Commission's reversal of Starlink's infrastructure award of $885.5 million. The appeal was filed electronically and hand-delivered to FCC Secretary Marlene Dorch. Polaris Dawn posted a tweet saying the Polaris Dawn crew recently visited Kennedy Space Center and Cape Canaveral in Florida for training and familiarization with Launch Complex 39A, launch day suit-up facilities and water recovery vessels. Somebody responded with, "We want to see the EVA suits." Somebody else responded to that with, "Just an IVA suit with an umbilical." Then finally, Jared Isaacman responded and said, "Not correct. What the SpaceX team is accomplishing with the new EVA suits is really incredible, worthy of a documentary in its own right." Heading to Boca Chica, work continued on the orbital launch mount for further testing. Here's a view of the top of the Megabay still being worked on. There was a picture posted on Reddit taken from a new paper released by NASA. It says NASA has released a new paper about Starship initial Artemis human landing system. The three different variants you see here will all be utilized for Artemis 3. During the week, SpaceX performed a relatively long full engine static fire of the Ship 24 prototype. After the static fire test had happened, there was a pretty big fire that happened in the area around the launch site. As well as that, there was a literal dumpster fire that happened inside the launch site. Fortunately, the infrastructure and prototypes at the launch site were all fine. SpaceX posted this really cool picture on Twitter of the Starship 24 prototype performing its static fire test. They said Ship 24 completes 6 engine static fire test at Starbase. After the static fire, Zach Golden posted a tweet with a picture of the Ship 24 heat shield. He said almost 30 damaged or missing tiles on Ship 24 after a 6 engine static fire test that lasted for 8 seconds. Musk responded with, "Yep, there's a reason we do static fires. Much better to break things on the ground than en route to orbit." Ship 25 has continued to be worked on inside the high bay. The crush test cap was seen being prepared to be removed from B7.1. The cap was then moved away from the launch site. At some point, B7.1 was also lifted off of the structural test stand. As well as the Ship 24 test during the week, Booster 7 performed the spin prime test with a lot of engines. Looking at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, obviously SpaceX did testing during the week. However, there is just one possible closure as of now for potential testing, which is tomorrow, Monday 12th. Booster 8 continues to be worked on in the Megabay. As always, I have to say thank you to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Starbase content in this video. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.